In this video, we're going to talk about sort of the underpinnings and the idea of discounting, which we began in the previous video. So I'll step off screen. Please copy it, pause it, and copy it down, and then I'll step back in. Okay, well, discount is based on compound interest. So let me just remind you what compound interest was. In compound interest, the interest is paid or accrued, depending on if you're borrowing money and paying the interest or lending the money and accruing the interest. So the interest arrives at the end of each time period. So for example, Fran could borrow $1 for 1 year from Trey at 5% annual compound interest. And at the end of that 1 year, she would pay back the $1 of principal and 5% more than the principal. So $1.05 back to Trey at the end of 1 year. Now, Trey might not like this idea. From his perspective, he's giving money away at time zero and getting nothing back until time one. So he might prefer to get some money out of Fran up front, sort of like a good faith collateral type payment. So Trey, the lender, may wish to receive the interest at the start of the period, not at the end of the period, all right? And this is called discounting. So the idea, I'm gonna walk through the idea via a conversation that Fran and Trey might have to illustrate how discounting differs from interest, from compound interest. Okay, so the situation begins when Fran asks to borrow $1 for 1 year from Trey at 5% annual compound interest. Right? And Trey says, sure, but please pay me the interest, 5 cents, right now, time zero, and then pay me back just the principal in 1 year's time. So give me the interest now, principal in a year, okay? Fran might say, okay, that's fine, but I'm not gonna pay you the 5 cents worth of interest right now. I will pay you the present value of that 5 cents worth of interest right now. Because remember, that 5 cents is to arrive in a year's time. So if we drag that back to time zero, that would be the present value of the 5 cents. So Fran says, fine, but I'll only pay you the present value of the interest due in 1 year, right now, time zero, and then I'll repay the dollar principal in 1 year. Trey agrees, whatever. Right? So thus, the transaction is, at time zero, Trey gives Fran $1. And Fran gives Trey that 5 cents worth of interest dragged back 1 year, so times V. Now, multiplying by V is multiplying by 1 over 1.05, in other words, dividing by 1.05. So Fran is actually giving Trey 4.76 cents. Now, there's not actually a Trey giving Fran money, Fran giving Trey money. Trey would just give Fran the dollar less that 4.76 cents of prepaid interest, right? So Trey would actually just give Fran 95.24 cents or $0.9524, yeah, at time. And then at time one, Fran would pay back Trey the full dollar, okay? So this is annual compound discount. So the annual compound discount was a percentage Fran paid Trey in interest at time zero. So that was 4.76%. We denoted D for discount, and it was linked to the compound interest rate I, which was 5% in this case. And how exactly was it linked? Well, if we took the $1 principal, Trey grabbed 4.76% of it back immediately for himself. So Fran actually got the $1 times 1 minus 0.0476 at time zero. And then this money got pushed forward 1 year. By the way, we know how to do 1 plus the interest rate I, in this case 0.05. And that turned out to equal that initial principal borrowed of $1. All right. I can cancel the $1. Sorry. I can move down here, there's my D, there's my I, but it's a replay of that higher equation. And if I cancel my $1, I get 1 minus T times 1 plus I equals 1. And that's the way we convert from one form to the other, from compound discount to compound interest or vice versa. And we'll see that more in the later videos.